I reset the game. I'm going to see if that might work. Okay. It is working. Oh my God, I swear that's so dumb. Basically, it looked like there was a small little update for the game, and that's what was preventing me from thing. Basically, I had to, like, shut the game down, then relaunch it to install the update. It's like, this is why I hate updates sometimes. And it's like, no. Like, it doesn't seem to affect... Okay, guys, I think I know what the problem was, why it disconnected me. It literally was, there was a small update for the game, and it booted me out of online, basically. When I shut the game down and relaunched it, it installed the new update. It literally happened just after I launched, but after it crashed, basically, so it was installing the update. But then when I shut it down and then relaunched it again, it's like, oh, here's an update installing. Took like a couple seconds to install it. And now I'm like stuck in space that I can't easily get to anything on my thing. So I might have to go back to my own instance again. But before I do that, actually, I'm going to utilize this space station while I'm here. Might as well. Yeah, basically. I figure I might as well farm some resources, right? Although I can see that big, stupid red space station you were talking about. It looks like a giant golf ball, almost. Okay, maybe I'm just blind and maybe it is a triangle. But it had a rounded end to it. Wow. Okay, and Okay. Oh, okay. Now I can actually see my hand in VR. Oh god. I can actually see my hands now. Oh, for like a second. I don't know. You'll see it. Oh, I see. It says Nova landed on Susan X. Susan X. It's the name of a planet. Am I getting, like, barraged with, like, party invites or something? No, because I keep hearing, like, the notification sound. I might as well gather some resources and some supplies, I guess. Ah, there's water on this planet. At least it looks like there is. Oh, right. Ships can't go underwater. Because they really gotta push you to use the new land and aquatic vehicles. Somehow. Extreme conditions. Ah! Goddamn gravity! How the hell do I go underwater?
out. Come on. Come on. Okay. The extreme heat on your plant here, Susan, is killing me here. No, I got the perfect name for this plant. Because apparently I can name some of your plant life here on your planet. Oh god, I'm such an idiot. God damn it. I'm trying to remember the spelling of a word. Because if I tell you the name, it'll spoil the fun. Ah, got the spelling. Well, you won't see the text anyways. I don't think the text shows up on stream. Oh, never mind, it does. Never mind. Oh. Ah, there we go. Ah, good old-fashioned butt scratchers! Butt scratchers here! And call these... They kind of just look like blood eggs. So I'm just going to call them what they look like. Blood eggs. That just looks like a cod, basically. Much better here. Much better. Much better. Oh God. Oh, I already know exactly what to name this fish. I know exactly what to name this fish. I know exactly what to name this fish. Wait, no. Fuck, I'm trying to think what the hell's, I can awkwardly name stuff after friends. Oh no, this one's more of this one. Anyways, there we go. This is now all stuff that has been named on Nova's planet, Susan X. There, I've corrupted the plants and fauna on his planet. And the name. Oh, I could apparently name the solar system because no one ever named it. I'll be nice. Name it after the person who's supposed to be the owner of this space, basically. Nova Space. There we go. I have claimed it. Hippity hoppity, this space has been renamed. Yeah. It's a shame I don't have the vehicles, otherwise I could go underwater. This planet... don't know. Well, the star system is literally called Nova Space. That should help. No, I mean like if I literally go to the space thing here. If I go here, go back. Look, the little solar system is literally called Nova Space. Susan X, Nova Space. Susan X is in Nova Space. Well, I don't know. I can check. Let me get off the planet. This planet's like an oven with like a swimming pool that I can't dip in because I don't have the ability to put vehicles on the planet. But what I did discover on Susan X, I can... Let's see, there's a space station. Looks like it's just called. I do not see a name on it. Arriving in 30 seconds, basically, to this unmapped planet. Oh. Oh. Oh, shit. Knocked over my glass. Well, yeah. That's why I said, oh shit. Yeah, it's just water, but still. Well, thankfully it didn't spill a lot because I put a soft drink lid on my cup, but still. The lid kept the majority of the spillage to a minimum. All I can say is remember shush about the names. Just let Nova discover that stuff on his own. he can see the monstrosities that I've, in a manner of speaking, created. Yeah, especially with the fact that I named a fish after him. Although, in hindsight, probably should have switched the names around. Maximize insult to injury. I could probably play some later. Give me a second here, just gonna... Oh god, I almost don't want to destroy those two rocks. They're so close together, it's like almost forming a, what looks like a butt. That you are. Very, very quiet. Okay, Nova Sus. I was in medbay doing task. And not in the ocean, naming his plants stupid names. Speaking of plants and junk that get dumb names. Ah, yes. The 420 Blazits. Let's just call it, Mama. Flower. Bush. That's all this plant is. It's just a bush. Gem ball. And this one we shall call butt ball. I'm gonna teach you about butt ball. First rule of butt ball: never tell your parents. Second rule of butt ball: never tell your parents. Good. Oh God. Yes. Yes. I shall name this world Buttball Land. And now Nova has to live with this planet, forever tainting his solar system. Full of gem balls and butt balls. Ah, good old 420 Blazits. And gem balls. And the 420 Blazits. Storm crystal. What the hell am I supposed to do with that? Oh, whatever the hell it was, I broke it. Oh, no, 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 no. That is not what we call it. We call these Starballs. Actually, you know what? Cracked. correct, Starballs. Mini cows? They look like little cows! They look like little mini cows! They're like pocket-sized! I call them mini moos! Which I have named Bootball Land. We do not question this. This is canon now. Moss weeds? Tall grass. Okay, if I can find a big looking horse thing, I'm gonna name it Butt Stallion. I'm having fun naming stuff. Oh, hey, Ultra. Sorry, I didn't see you! the chat is, like, just at the bottom of my peripheral vision. So, just about, here in my point of view. Like, right where my wrist is. Like, I guess the easiest way to describe it is, like, I'm touching my chin right now, basically. And that's what that ring is. Like, I know you can see a lot more of the thing than I can, so I do apologize. But, hey, sir. Ah, the infamous Karen Flytrap returns to another planet to seek her vengeance on managers far and wide throughout the galaxy. So, we gotta name this the Karen Flytrap. Karen Flytrap. It's big, pulsating, and spits out toxic sludge. I shall call this Mike. I don't need to dignify the reasoning behind that. A giant star that I remember finding underwater. Let's name that, let's name it Patrick. My character like just automatically clings to the ceiling. Okay. That's how I swim underwater in VR. Okay. I was wondering how the hell I did it. I have to pull down the right stick for camera view. Okay, that thing actually creeps me the hell out. Apparently it's called an abyssal horror. Where the hell did the eye roll to? Okay, let's, guess... Okay. Okay. J-E-L-O. Jelly. Butt fish. I have such mature humor. The height of maturity. Deliberately misspelt. Haha. Goldie rocks. Actually, I'm gonna check my chat really quick. Thank you, thank you. I love the name. I love me the Goldie Rocks. It is a big boy. Okay, big body, tiny head. Oh yeah, this is definitely a majestic creature known as the Butt Stallion. Oh shit, I typed in Butt Stallion! Whoops! Oh, that's the name now! That is the name! Butt Stallion! These are names that will now forever be written into the. What's in your solar system? No, that planet's still called Susan X. I can't change that name. I'm on a different planet. That is near Susan X. Susan X got too hot, so I had to leave. Well, I mean, that's one way of putting it. I did not hit her. I did not. I'm sorry, what? Give me a second here. I don't know. I mean, not really too interested in dating a planet. Well, I mean, if I want to date a planet, I could just go out to the back of my building, dig a small hole, and just go to town on it, and just be like, yeah, I'm begging the Earth. Same effect. No! Yeah, sorry. The only people who date planets are simps. I'm not one of those. However, I will gladly donate to a planet's only fans. I'm what? Hmm? There's like a 5-10 second delay on the stream. Yeah, as I said, there's like a 5-10 second delay on the stream. And that's on my end, it's a 5-10 second delay, because that's just how the PlayStation stream works. So it could be a greater delay because of your internet bandwidth. I mean, technically Rick did bang a planet. I mean, yeah, he technically did bang a planet. Like, literally, bang a planet. Okay, I just landed on the space station. A bunch of ships flew out and tried to attack me the minute I came near it. Can't attack me now, mother huggers! Bunch of more. Ask about other travelers. Ask about 16. Up to my own base. The only thing is I won't be able to warp back because I need power. I never set up a power supply on my planet. This is definitely something.
Okay. Zipping around at the speed of sound. Got places to go, gotta follow the rainbow. All the drugs. No. I took all the drugs. All of them. You better put... I mean, you're not exactly wrong about all the amazing exhibits that are available at Buttball Land. Shh. They don't need to know about that. Okay, got the biofuel reactor. Electrical wiring. Buttball Land, come on down to Buttball Land. If you don't come down to Buttball Land, you'll die in a crimson fire and I'll probably shoot your family to death. Come down to Buttball Land today. If you don't, we'll fucking kill your family. Promise. Promise.
Thank you. Stranger, stranger. Now that's a Buttball Land.
First rule of Buttball Land. Don't tell your parents. Don't tell your parents. That's it. There's only two rules. Don't tell your parents. Okay. I now have a portal that is available for use. Well, now that I have my teleporter online, you can actually teleport to my planet now. No need. That was Nova, I believe. Okay, let's see. What else do I need to build? Okay. I need more salvage data so I can build a save beacon. Or not, apparently.
Actually, you know what? I don't really need a save point. I've already got this. Why do I need to make a save point when I can just use the one that's already on the site? Okay, now I need to build wire. Grid overload. I need to build batteries.
Temperature levels stabilizing.
Okay. Health station, so for healing, I can heal it. Solar panel and battery. Okay, that's what I need to get next. So I need to get more salvage data. God, did the game? Goodbye, Dino Dog.
Goodbye.
It's not that bad. Like, I'll admit it's not my best, but I mean, I don't like... Like, I appreciate any viewers I get. Anyways, I need to... Yo, what's up? Probably. I know there's tons of plants for carbon. I'll take a look around. Well, I'll tell you if I spot any, okay? Also, I'm no longer in your solar system. I'm actually all the way back in mine.
Because I apparently could use the teleporter to get all the way to my planet. The heck is this thing? Fridays and Saturdays. He can stream whatever the hell he wants. He can stream at the same time as me if he wants to. Yeah, he could stream right now if he wanted to. I found a merchant on my planet. Well, it's your call if you want to, but there are other days where I want to stream with other friends, just to be perfectly clear on that. Because I hate to sound like that guy, but I do have other friends. Starship. Decrypt archive. Well, and can't this game go up to, like, how many players can be in this game? Like, what, 4? Okay. I think I might do some editing stuff, possibly. Okay, let's see. I found an artifact exchange vault. If you have any... Oh, that's right! I gave you some artifacts the other day. Kind of, well, not the other, like, in-game time, I should say, to be fair. You could come down to where I am right now. There's an artifact exchanger. This base isn't actually all that far from mine. Okay, this planet actually has a lot more value to me now. Good.
I see you're flying toward Koga. Actually, I should probably check and see if I can name anything near me. Stone drop? And there's still one more animal that needs to be found on my planet. Yep, there's one more animal hiding around here somewhere on this planet that I'm on. Which is, technically a moon. It's, Bob's moon, Roto. You, gentlemen. How much do you want for this, ship? Make an offer for Lifeform's ship. Let's see, he wants... how much? How much does he want? He wants 24 million for this. It's a little better than what I... oh, actually, no, not, it's not a little. It is a lot better than my B-class ship. God damn. It has, like, a crap ton of slots on it for storage. I mean, that's one way to go about it, I guess. Although, I feel like this guy's not going to be here for very long, though. Because the ships kind of come and go quite frequently. So I don't know if I'd be able to wait. Oh well. It's still a cool ship though. Oh, I actually like it better than the B-class one I have. Damn. Well, easy way to kind of help increase my revenue stream is to discover more shit. Oh, I guess someone else already identified this, so I can't even name it. I guess when you guys discovered this plant already. Because apparently you left it with a default name. Oh well. Are you talking about the mushroom thing that has like drops hanging off of it? You renamed it, didn't you? What did you name it to? Should I be scared? M. Misjavash. It's the default name. Maybe I have to go like offline for a bit and then come back on for to see the name change. Because I think it has to upload the names to this. I have to like basically acquire the names from the server. There you go, giant sodium crystals. Well, I have no idea how the hell I'm supposed to get that. There's a thing underground, but I can't seem to punch through. Don't specify. Like, it's just a floor panel, but I can't blast through it. I kind of figured. I know that my sister was saying that I should probably look into getting myself Skyrim VR. I wouldn't know. I've heard that game doesn't really translate too well to VR. But I mean, I've never actually owned or played Skyrim. I know, sacrilege in today's gaming society. Well, I've never really been too big into the Elder Scrolls series as a whole. Well, I prefer to play games generally vanilla if I can. That's the thing, I don't really care for modding too much. Yeah, but the thing is, the problem is, I've been told that, like, with when it comes to Bethesda games in general, with the exception of Fallout, you kind of have to mod. Okay, I've lost track of the damn thing that I was supposed to be coming down here for. I suppose. I mean, hell, I was able to play Morrowind way back in the day, which I would argue is still, in my opinion, my favorite Elder Scrolls game. I didn't like Oblivion very much. Because I feel like they focus too much on having star power attached to that one. Because
They actually had some celebrities involved in that one. Yeah, I don't think I'm able to dig around this. I think it might just be one of those things where it's just due to procedural generation, it's put in a spot where it just can't be dug up. Here's hoping you can get it done. Honestly, I don't know what the hell a living ship is. Is it like an organic ship? So wait, you're working on building one or repairing one? Oh, that's gonna be creepy as all hell. You just come down with your flesh ship, just big flappy meat wings, just. Yeah! I have no idea what you're talking about. Those bodies were like that when I got here. I have no idea what you're talking about. It was clearly the work of an imposter. Who is devilishly handsome. Are my eyes? No, that really looks like it's glowing. Oh, it's a copper deposit! Yeah, but I might as well mine it. Okay, I better summon my ship. Let's put down a signal booster, I guess.
No free slots in ship inventory.
Okay. I will say mining is a lot easier in VR. Because, like, literally, you just aim the gun. And it literally just, it's like, oh, okay. I'm gonna need to melt some of that and some of that. Then also you can get a good detailed look at your gun model. I mean, that's always kind of cool, right? Not gonna lie, this thing looks like something out of Borderlands. I half expect to be able to throw this and it grows out stilt legs and starts running around shooting bandits. All right, then. And he was never heard from again. Now, I think he's doing an exploit with the time manipulation. You know, similar to how, like, with Animal Crossing, you can manipulate the game by fucking with the time settings on your Switch. Cool, I found another beacon. And stuff is floating. Because, of course, fuck gravity. Oh, I shall definitely name this waypoint, What is Gravity? Oh, apparently there is no waypoint here, but damage machine. Oh, it's just a beacon. Whoa, what the fucking hell? God damn it, Karen! It's always Karen snapping at me. I love that I named that plant Karen. It fits it so perfectly.
Okay. Okay, I remember there was a... Okay, it's gonna take me about a minute to get to where I need to go. Welcome back. Let's see. Okay, this multi-tool is worse than what I have. But it looks like it'd be better for combat? So I might consider buying this just for combat, specifically. But at the same time, it's like, I could get that bolt caster attachment and just attach it onto mine. And make my multi-tool into a fucking weapon. Pardon my French. Let's see, what's this boy got? Request exosuit or weapon upgrade? Oh, weapon. Exosuit upgrade. Okay. Okay. Time to fly Polly out of here. Rest your face. Really? You laugh at that? I'll just name this one a really obvious name. Stop and Shop. Because there's literally a guy that sells you shit. Can't really get more straightforward than that. Ooh. There is a weird texture glitch here. Where, like, part of the wall isn't rendered on the outside. And I can see inside from outside. That is so weird. Oh, and there's no collision in a section of the wall. And what do you mean by that's tame? Really that odd, if you stop to think about it. that's the upgrade he put on my suit. I have an additional inventory slot. I know I saw an ore deposit. Gotta let my jetpack recharge a bit. Whoop. I did not break my legs. I did not break my legs. I said I didn't break him! Nope. Be gone, Karen! Ah, that's the deposit right there, okay. There we go. I knew I saw this. Oh, and of course there's a Karen sitting on top. God, I will never get over the fact that I named it Karen. You know, it's funny that technically this is still an indie game. It's just, it's like one of the few games that had like a AAA advertising budget, basically. I mean, hell, technically, Kojima Productions is an indie company. If you want to get technical. The only thing is they got AAA budget right out of the gate because of the fact that they had big name people within the company. But I mean, if you ever wanted to make an indie company blow up seemingly overnight, just get a big name like Kojima on board and boom, you're basically guaranteed to get in. Although, actually, speaking of that, I just remembered, actually, when Kojima's name got removed from Metal Gear, it kind of just made me remember that a couple indie games actually put Kojima in their credits, even though he had nothing to do with their games whatsoever. For example, I believe one of them was a Goat Simulator. You sound like you're tired. I was saying Nova. Ah, he's starting to hit with the, what the hell is it called? The crash.
The elusive crush. Ho ho ho. Oh. Enchanté.
Okay, I better go back to my ship before I die out here. I'd rather not waste the liftoff fuel just to have it travel a small distance to pick me up and then travel the rest of the way. I'd rather just walk to my ship. Although I do need to get another suit upgrade at some point to upgrade my stamina. I burn through it way too quickly. Also, I will say, unlike Minecraft and VR, I don't feel sick while playing this. Because I tried playing Minecraft in VR, although maybe it's just the particular version of Minecraft I was playing. Because I was playing on a PC at a Microsoft event, but their VR was capped off at I think it was like around 30 frames, and just, I don't know. Come on. We're landing, boys. I said landing! Ah, good old money. Okay, let's see. I've gone to 6 a.m. before. I don't know why it seems that weird. I am running out of room. Whatever. I'll just miss it on whatever items are there. I don't have the room for it. English, super strong language. Oh, there we go. That's what I need. A wooden half ramp. Oh, but I can't build that until I get wooden ramp. Okay, now I can build the ramp. Come on. There we go. I have now got a little staircase going up to my base. I know that's more for cosmetic reasons, but still. Now I have it set up. I haven't even done anything with like the quote unquote ground level building yet. Now I have to fiddle with a jump to get in. Okay, construction device. Build technology. And let's build the battery. Oh. Wait, how much salvage data do I have? I have 2 salvage data. Okay, I need more salvage data. Where the heck are my ships? You know what I just realized? I should probably get out of my ship and refine this before I forget. Because I know you can refine the scrap metal to basically become usable metal. So, rusted metal. Loading some carbon.
champ.
Okay, let's see, where can I go? Okay, let's see. You guys have anything interesting going on over there, or? I'm sorry, what about your mom? I still need to find out where the hell that final animal is. There's gotta be like water or something on this planet somewhere. That, or it's just a cave-dwelling creature. I should probably just go back to my base. I swear, I don't know what it is. I love how the body's just ragdoll in this game. And if you hit them ever so slight with your laser, like, they just spin out of control. It's like... Begin decryption. Finds their wings. Claim your place among the stars. You know what? I think I can call it quits for now. Yeah, probably later. I'm just gonna take a break, get something to eat. Anyways, till next time, this is Timothy signing out, and have a good one.